I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Central Valley. It's Danny and Raquel here with your announcements for today, May 8th, 2018.
Please donate a gently used hoodie for the 2018-2019 school year. These will be distributed to the underprivileged students at the beginning of the school year. Please drop sweatshirts off in room NB114, Mrs. Jones's room. Thank you for participating.
The library will be closed for the week of May 1st. The library will reopen on Tuesday, May 8th during Academic Study Hall. The last day to check out books for the year is Thursday, May 10th. All library books need to be returned to the library by Friday, May 25th. If you currently have an overdue book checked out, please return it to the library as soon as possible.
This is a reminder that if you have received an invitation to the Pirate game on Wednesday, May 16th, please give your money and permission slip to Ms. Salon or Mr. Vakobakan. Only the first 80 students will be able to attend.
The Peace Club will be holding two fundraisers next week from May 7th to the 11th. Summer baskets will be raffled off during lunch and study halls. Tickets are $1 for $1, $3 for $2, or $10 for $5. An Alex and Ani Living Water bracelet will also be auctioned off for $1 per ticket. You can buy yourself or a friend a Peace Gram, which is an inspirational cup of candy to brighten up someone's day and make them feel appreciated. Lastly, see a Peace Club member to purchase a CV No Hate Zone t-shirt, Warrior joggers, a CV Stylus pen phone holder for only $2, a CV Yeti type tumbler, or Warrior headbands. You can also see Ms. Zillion for any of these items at NB113. All proceeds from the fundraiser will benefit a nonprofit organization aimed at promoting and keeping peace and also providing water to those nations who struggle to find it on a daily basis. Thank you for your help.
That's all we have for you today, CB. Now here is Noah and Jackie with your sports.
Good morning, Central Valley. It's Noah and Jackie here with your sports for today.
The boys' baseball team has a home game against Ambridge at 4.
The softball team has an away game at 4:15 against Hopewell.
Now here's Danny and Nate with your joke of the week.
Hey, CB. Danny and Nathan here with your joke of the week.
Let's see what you got this time.
All right. What did the Dalmatian say after lunch? That hit the spot.
You think he had a hot dog for lunch?
I don't know, good question. Hey, we'll be back next week with another joke.
Hello, CB. I'm here with a segment on the Mr. Beaver County event.
The Prevention Network and the Beaver County Team Leadership Committee hosted the Mr. Beaver County 2018 event at 6:30 p.m. on April 12th at the Central Valley High School.
It is an annual drug-free event that is funded by Beaver County Drug and Alcohol Unit.
Mr. Beaver County is an anti-drug and alcohol-free scholarship event sponsored by the Prevention Network for junior and senior young men in Beaver County.
All schools in the county are invited to send representatives. Some schools have their own events and send the winner and the first runner-up.
The schools also have the option to send another student who may be interested in participating.
The activities for the night include physical fitness, an inspirational segment, talent, formal wear with escorts, and a fishbowl question.
The panel of judges from different county agencies scored and announced the first runner-up and the winner of Mr. Beaver County.
We took the time to interview our Mr. Beaver County representatives. Check it out.
Hello, Central Valley. I'm here with Mr. Beaver County contestant Mark Palumba.
How you doing, John?
Good. How are you?
I'm fantastic.
So how was the Mr. Beaver County event?
It was really cool, actually. I was called down to the prevention office. So I was very confused why I was going down there. But they asked if they wanted me to participate in it, and I was like, yeah, sure. And Jake sure participated, and Aaron Swagger, too. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I heard it was a lot of fun. So how was the whole experience for you, as in not knowing, like going into it blind, basically?
You weren't completely blind because Mrs. Graziano really helps you out a lot in, you know, telling you what to do and what you have to prepare for. Like, there's a talent portion, there's a fishbowl question you have to answer something, yeah, like randomly.
Uh-huh.
And there's a couple different events that are pretty cool, and you get to meet a lot of different people from different schools, and it's a really awesome event altogether.
Yeah, it sounds very fun. What's a piece of advice that you would give to anybody else doing it next year?
I would say just like prepare what you're going to say, because there's also a positive person event. Mm-hmm. So you can pick someone that you're going to talk about that has made an impact in your life. So yeah, just prepare that, and in the talent portion, just, you know, have that prepared to just be
talented.
Yeah, well, something like that.
All right, thank you, Mark.
Yep.
Hi, I'm here with Aaron Swagger, who was the first runner-up at the Mr. Beaver County event. So how was that event?
It was really cool. I got to meet a lot of people from different schools, and they're all like super talented, and everyone was just really nice, and it was a really fun time in general.
And do you have any advice for people that want to participate next year?
Just do something that you're good at, I guess.
What was your talent?
I sang a song.
Well, thank you.
Hey, yeah. CB, I'm here with Jake Schur, Mr. Beaver County contestant. So Jake, how was the Mr. Beaver County event?
It was an amazing experience, John.
What was the most exciting part about it?
Probably meeting every single person there. They were all in musical, so it was a great experience.
What was your talent?
I played the flugelhorn and trumpet. I played the song You Raise Me Up.
That's awesome, that's awesome. So for anybody who wants to do it next year, what some advice you'd like to give them?
Actually practice your talent.
Yeah, you don't want to get any blind on that.
Yeah.
All right, thanks, Jake.
Yep.
As you can see, our Mr. Beaver County representatives are very deserving of the invitation.
They represent our school very well and set a great example inside as well as outside of our school.
Make sure you learn more about the event for next year if you're interested in either attending or being invited as a participant.
We hope you have a great day, CB.